There are two kinds of elections, it seems to me. In one kind of national election, there is agreement on what the problem is, but disagreement about the solutions. And in a different kind of election, there is a disagreement even on the identity of the problems. Now, for a long time, I have believed that this election is going to be closer to a type 1 election than a type 2 election. That is, everybody agrees the problem is the economy. The question is what to do about it. And at a very high level of generality, that is true. But after listening to Mitch Daniels' response to the president last night, I'm a little bit less sure that it's true when you go down a level. The president is talking about the jobs feature of the economy. Mitch Daniels, on behalf of the Republicans, and I think accurately representing them, is talking about the size, the scope, and the cost of government as the key feature of the economy. And the Republican argument, stripped to its essentials, is that it is the size and scope and cost of the economy that is dragging the economy down. And so the Republican agenda focuses a lot more on the fiscal issues, the tax reform issues, et cetera, about which the president was conspicuously, as Pietro pointed out, nearly silent, and as Karen Dinan pointed out in the previous panel, nearly silent. And so you have, if not dueling agendas, very different conceptions of what the economic problem actually is. And part of what's going on in this general election will be a fight for the control of the agenda. And if the Mitch Daniels-style argument about what the core economic problem is prevails, then the Republican nominee, whoever he may turn out to be, and interestingly, only one of the two front runners complies with the Buffett rule at this point, and it's not Mitt Romney. Then we have one kind of election. But if the president's framing of the problem prevails, we're going to have a very different kind of election.